Well, speaking of this holiday theme, candy canes at this time of the year are just plain sweet. But for one family in the Sierra foothills, it's part of their heritage. KPIX 5 Sharon Chin takes us to Northern California's oldest candy shop and gets a lesson in making candy canes the old-fashioned way.
In Columbia State Historic Park, where Main Street is preserved from the Gold Rush days, a visit to Nelson's Columbia Candy Kitchen is like looking through a window of history. Mike McMahon measures sugar and water to create Nelson's signature foot-long candy canes.
It's like working with glass almost, you know, like the glass blowers.
From shiny copper kettles to marble tables, he uses equipment that's more than a century old and recipes from the 1800s.
Nobody looks at a candy cane the same after they see this.
Mike is part of the Nelson family, which has handmade confections for five generations. Among the youngest, his nephew, Max Voorhees.
I had been around it my whole childhood, and I probably made my first batch of candy canes at 5 or 6.
Max's grandmother, Janice Nelson, runs the business.
This is a great lifestyle and a great heritage and tradition to carry on.
Mike, who's Janice's son-in-law, has made candy here for 28 years. He showed me how he cooks 35 pounds of candy canes a day during the holidays. The hot sugary syrup gets cooled on a special table. Part of it gets colored red, while the rest reaches the right temperature and texture. Then the peppermint flavor goes in as Mike pulls the mixture on a hook to stretch out air bubbles till it turns white like satin. He presses it all together and keeps it warm on a spinning table from 1911. Mike snips off sections, but we have only seconds to shape them before the sugar hardens.
Put your crook in the top.
I can feel it starting to harden here.
Yes, okay. Yes, and there you go.
We have a candy cane.
Janice says a Danish candy maker and his wife actually set up the shop here on Main Street 96 years ago. One of their employees, a former coal miner named Rex Nelson, bought the business in 1936. Rex was Janice's grandfather-in-law, and when he died 50 years ago, Janice and her late husband Michael moved from Southern California to Columbia to take over.
I came to this town the first time 50 years ago, and it was magical.
The family stayed in business with new flavors like coconut pineapple ribbons and old favorites like chocolate almond bark and honeycomb, hand-dipped by longtime employees.
Yeah.
And snapped up by customers like Karen Bissett.
There's candy here you can't get anywhere else. I come here because every time I leave, I'm happy.
For Janice and her family, making candy is part joy.
Everybody's always smiling. That's the best part.
And part art.
That's a wreath. Nice.
When you get a really, really beautiful candy cane, it's nice.
And Nelson family members hope to keep sharing their twist on their sweet heritage for generations to come.
KPIX. Merry Christmas.
In Columbia, Sharon Chin, KPIX 5.
If you've never made it to Columbia, by the way, I have to tell you, you are missing out. You should really head up there. It's a fantastic state park. During the holidays, the Nelson family invites members of the public to learn to make candy just like Sharon did. There's a lottery. They take about 100 people per weekend. Ah.